Literally, that's the only actual RNG part. If I got one more shitty reset, I'm just gonna do Black Knight Great Axe instead. Cause I don't wanna work on Broken Straight Sword today. It sounds like a pain. Get mad, not anymore. If you want to see me being mad, go watch my Pyromancy Any% run. Just the beginning, I'm on like a fucking 10 minute rant. Cause I was stuck in early game for like an hour and literally got nowhere. It was fucking annoying. Annoying. It's not even an hour setup. It's like, well, unless you do dung pies on Quaylag, which on that run I didn't, because I was being lazy. Did the quick swipe back hop. Funny. Yeah, it's down in my about. I know it's getting a little bit cluttered, but still. Oh nice, I didn't get both parts of the plunge. Lol. Fuck me, I guess. Kind of fun one-shotting things, yeah, it can be. And then it gets boring, honestly. For me, it got boring really quick. It's like, okay. Yeah, I can one-shot things, but I don't really have trouble fighting them to begin with. And it's just more setup than usual. Because, like, I could run a low setup sorcery build, but that's annoying as well. I do as well. That's why I fight pretty much everything the same way, even when I run sorcery. Like, people for some reason try to fight bosses differently with sorcery than melee, and that's stupid. In, like, every case, that's just stupid. It's like people sometimes, like, outspace four kings when they're using magic instead of strafing them. Like, why? You literally lose an attack opportunity. It's dumb. Just because you're using something different doesn't mean you need to change how you play. Not even, but it's a lot easier to dodge the swipe. It's not mandatory, it's just, you know, easier. Needs distance to gain velocity or impact. Nah, the air resistance slows down the magic. They lose damage, totally. I mean, in DS2, you lose a little bit of damage with range with magic. So, maybe the air resistance thing is actually true in DS2. Such a weird number. Like, why 13 strength? Same using magic or melee, as it should be. The only time you should ever really change how you play is with something very, very slow, like a great bow or sniper crossbow. Or I guess lightning spear. Don't. Just don't. They're bad. Well, the great bows are fine. They have enough stagger. But sniper crossbow is shit. And I mean, you barely change anything anyway. It's basically just, instead of like three attacks, you can only get one. My mouse feels too small. Yeah. Also with S-Dock, which I did recently. Yeah, but my mouse is too small, it feels like. It's like my pinky finger has nowhere to go on the mouse. So I have to like curl it up. I'm dead. Almost. I probably have like somewhat big hands, but I don't know if the mouse is small. Painting Guardian Sword, yeah, it's pretty good. It says Commandro. I have no clue what it is. Paws, not hands, yeah. I am a cat. Hey, sir. I don't think you're gonna like it, Zerk. It was already redeemed. Sorry, your day is ruined. You don't care, damn. Sometimes Meow goes unredeemed for like half the stream. As they should. Where are you off to? Community challenges are like a massive fucking point sink. There's one person I'm watching, I put like, I think 90k into a community challenge. It's kind of ridiculous. Like, it's to the point I've actually ran out of points. Just die. Christ. I don't feel like doing the backstab thing, so I just do stupid shit instead. 6, 7, 8. Nine, and I can't see if there's a 10. No, it's just a game that Wesley wanted me to play. And so I said, if you give me 1,000,000 points, I'll do it. Apparently there's like 2 RNG parts near the end, and it's like a less than an hour run, I think. And there's stuff I can do to lessen the RNG. So, it's not like a game that lends itself to no hit, is really what it is. Like, I'm sure it's a fine game, it's just not the kind of game that you would immediately think of when you think of no hit. Because of RNG. At least partly. No, it's like, I don't even know what to call it. It's definitely not, though. It's like, you, from what I understand, you, like, go, like, talk to people, and, like, there are certain checks for, like, combat or whatever. It's that kind of game. Yeah, that's what I understand it to be, Zerk, basically. And you need to, like, stop, like, not have your insanity go up and not take damage or something like that. I don't really know. I've never really seen gameplay of it. I'm just kind of taking a shot in the dark with how it's been described to me. Like D&D without the fantasy, damn. I thought I didn't send it up. Yeah, but basically all it is just a game that is not like a typical no-hit thing. And maybe I'll lower the point value to like 100k at some point when I'm like done with other stuff, but for now, it's not really something I want to do. I got too much on the docket already. Yeah, and that's not it. These runs, the other runs in DS1, Dark Souls 2, Munisid, Subnautica, maybe Death's Gambit. Yeah, I might do Subnautica, no damage. I don't think all scans is possible, but I might try. I might try to do max scans, maybe. Reaper Levite, well, it'd be no damage. So any kind of environmental damage, any Leviathans, the little crab crawlers when you're on land or on the ship, on the Aurora. It's not what I meant. I thought I was on the Homeward Bone. I'm gonna run to the restroom, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So yeah, Zerk, the whole lava area would be like something you can't go through without getting a prawn suit. So there's that. And I would assume it's just player damage that counts as a hit. Not like you're gonna be in ships much, so. Going back like 10 minutes, speaking of real-time strategy, haven't there been like literally real-time strategy games, like challenges done in some where you don't lose a single unit? It's fucking crazy. Nah, Subnautica would be basically intense memorization and a bit of luck. With, outcrop droppings, droppings, drops with outcrops. It's basically just extreme resource management. It's like, okay, you need 57 titanium, 32 copper, blah, 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 blah. And I need this much at this point, that much at this point, that kind of thing. That's more what it would be along the lines of. Okay. Well, I didn't get a backstab, which is stupid. There's also a game called Alien Swarm Reactive Drop that I want to try to beat each campaign without taking any hits or damage solo. Just a speedrun route? Probably. I mean, there is literally a no damage any percent speedrun category in Subnautica, so I'm not exactly breaking new ground there. I would literally just be following that route. Pretty much like Lunacid, honestly. But I mean, look where we are with Lunacid now. I'm making the speedrun routes. Oh, how the turntables. Pathing, by the way. Holy shit, I'm bad. I can't even select the proper menus. It's crazy. Yeah, but with Alien Swarm Reactive Drop, there's actually... There's actually like a whole like challenge system. So you can put on like one hit mode, which is what I would be using. And if you don't know what the game is, it's like a top-down shooter game, I guess. There's also a third-person and a first-person challenge mode, but I wouldn't really touch those, because those make it more difficult. It also just looks weird. Yeah, but I would try to do each campaign without taking a hit. Individually, I wouldn't try to do them all one after another, because that would be, like, near impossible. I have one chunk. One extra chunk, I should say. I didn't fucking stagger him because there wasn't counter damage on the last hit. Lol. Tired.
And then,
any records in Lethal Company? No. Trying for one though. If I wanted a record, I could get one today. Because there's several categories that just have no records at the moment. So if I wanted the record, I would just run that category and be the only person who has, or the only group that has. I'm honestly, like, at this point, I'm more into the challenge moons than trying to get a record. But I don't have anyone who's, like, willing to seriously run challenge moons with me constantly. Like, I have people willing to run challenge moons, but not people willing to put, like, 30 hours into the same moon. Which kind of sucks. Yeah, but I mean, yesterday I was joking with one of the people I was playing with, and we were like, the trio single day clear records for most moons are worse than the solo and the duo. So we could go for trio single day clear records pretty easily. Because trios are not competitive at all. Solos are pretty competitive, duos are competitive, squads are competitive, trios not so much. There's also modded records I could go for if I cared. But I mean, it's pretty safe to say, you're not bad, Zerk, firstly. It's pretty safe to say most records I would set, would not stand for very long in the face of serious competition. Because I am pretty, I'm like, pretty fucking like, I'm decent at Lethal Company, but that's about as far as you could push it. Like, I'm okay. What's being decent at Lethal Company? Knowing how to deal with the monsters, knowing routes, knowing tech, I guess. Like, I know what I'm supposed to do, I just need to get better so I can execute at a higher level. Why are you not a pro? You are a pro. As you so often say to me, pro. I mean, it's not about even being a pro. It's literally just about knowing what to do in different situations. That's a lot of what Lethal Company is. Like, you can know what to do with individual monsters, but where I begin to struggle is dealing with multiple. And that's why I say I'm only decent. Nice. Yeah, I'm not even entirely sure that was Imperium, because that, like, we had Bracken not spawn and Spider not spawn one time when I didn't have Imperium on. So I'm not entirely sure what was going on there. Oh my god, nice fucking hockey stop. Nice. Just fucking perfect. I need you to not go that way, actually. Like, I'm not entirely sure what was happening on that moon. That was pretty bad. I really feel like we could clear that one though. The one that you were doing with us, Zerk. I feel like if we just got better with our routing, we could clear that. Get the soccer balls back early. It would just be really about getting the cashies and the soccer balls back early. Maybe shoveling Bracken to make me able to go faster. Cause there's a place in your kitchen that's pretty open that you could probably shovel Bracken at and then kill Spider. And the coil spawns in kind of an out of the way place, cause we should have upper right cleared by the time coil spawns. Same with slime. Kazoo is like what, 33 items, something like that? Or 43? I don't remember. I think it was 33. I actually want more stamina right now. It was like at most 3 trips per person. It was like 2 to 3 trips per person, I think. So between like 32 and 48, I guess. Because, I mean, both the cashies are actually pretty close to fire as well, so it's not like there's a ton of transport time from really deep. Bro, come on. Honestly, I'm not sure Zeekers ever, like, checks to make sure the challenge moons are, like, fully clearable. I think it's literally just people say fuck it and then just grind it and are able to full clear most of the time. It's funny. I don't think Zeekers really gives a shit if it's clearables because it's a weekly challenge. This is the... Yeah, and the fact that Zekers just keeps the out-of-bound teleport back to main thing on Challenge Moon instead of fixing out-of-bound items is ridiculous. Is that, like, actually fucking ridiculous? It's like, it's well-known shit. Just, Seekers doesn't give a damn, I guess. Oh my god. That guy needs to go. Bro, come on. Thank you. Good luck with the mad scientist stuff. Thank you for the good luck on the run, sir. Hey Mirko, how you doing? Winged spear, indeed. Fuck me, why did I, like, turn my camera so weirdly? Like, what was that? Watching while at work, because you're so responsible. You are responsible. Getting your daily dose of fucking caddy's bullshit. What a responsible consumer. Dude, I'm actually so fucking dog shit at this game. Fire Sage, fucking asshole. Where are you off to? Oh. If this lizard gives me a chunk, I don't need to get another one. To do the resin skip? Or I guess the fucking door skip? Chaos Blade? Alright. I don't need to get an extra chunk! Yay! Or what? Because I messed it up, ring slot. Brother. it's not that bad. It's kind of annoying that there's collision as well as a hitbox, but it won't generally be a problem for most things. Just actually falling asleep. Okay, let's see if this fucking Dark Wraith shows up again when we go back. Because, like, he showed up twice and he's never shown up before.
Thank you.
land. Thank you.
Is it not?
After I kill the golem or get hit, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Okay, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. I'll be back in a minute. Whoa! Whoa there, bud! Calm the fuck down. Whoa-ho-ho. Hello to you too. Oh my god, move! I didn't hear the arrow, and then I did, and then I got stuck. That was a clusterfuck. Thank you. brother. Okay, so that guy's aggroing because I'm like partly off the thing, is what's happening. So, I literally just need to stop doing that. Hold on. I need to stop going so far to the side, is what I mean. Why would you ever open with anything different? Bro, fuck off. I was not that far from you. I don't, like... Fuck off, like, really? Yeah, especially when they fucking two of them. Watch me get a third. Oh wow, I didn't get a third one? Are you sure? God. Are you absolutely sure you don't want to do a homing magic attack? How fucking kind. I played that so damn bad. God. This song reminds me of a fucking, like, joke video I saw. It was, like, making fun of emo music, but it was, like, really funny. I kinda want the song just because it makes me laugh. I don't even know if it's on Spotify, I really doubt it, because it was made as a joke. It's obviously pretty bad, but like... joke songs are just like... I don't know. I like them sometimes, other times they're just dumb. Do some heroin. Wake me up, I'm doing lots of drugs. From doing all these drugs. Oh my god. This song is just such a joke. I love it. Okay. Sorry, I was responding to something.
Mom, I want to die. Hey, Mom, I want to die. No one'll miss me if I take my life.
That whole section of the song is fucking just goofy. It's just fucking goofy. Whole thing is, but like still. Get out of here. I love that bit at the end. It's just so fucking stupid. Ohio's for Emo Kids is like top tier joke song. Well, how you doing? Hope you're well. Yeah, I'm doing all right. Run's going pretty decent. Thank you. Thank you for the GG. So much better than what you were doing, yeah. It's literally just 9k free souls. It's barely a time loss, like, unless you're a speedrunner, you really should not care about like a 2-3 minute time loss. Especially considering it makes the rest of the early game flow a lot better. Yeah, it's a good amount. Yeah, I mean, depends on what you want to do and what you do late game. I mean, like with late game, what upgrade path are you gonna take? Like, that's more what I mean than anything. Standard? Yeah. Are you doing any percent? I'd say for any percent, you can honestly just go plus 10. Like, unless you're not confident doing plus 10 four kings. Because you lose like 2-3 minutes doing a very large ember or getting very large ember. And then you have to get the chunks as well, which is more out of the way stuff. Unless you go to Great Hollow, which is just a free 2. Which is, you know, plus 12 immediately. Doing Great Hollow? Yeah, okay, then. Less out of the way for upgrade materials. You'll maybe probably hit plus 13. I'd say beyond that is RNG. You can skip, so 11 and 12 is from the tree, and then 13 would be from one giant and the one by the giant blacksmith in Anor Londo. So unless you're trying to go plus 14, I would say it's not worth killing the Black Knight. Yeah, I mean the difference between 13 and 14 is pretty minimal. So I would say, unless you're fine losing the time from killing the gate opening giant and the Black Knight, then it's not worth it. Yeah, especially with an ultra, you're not really gonna take too many hits to kill things. honestly, in my opinion, once you start doing like a standard upgrade route with an any percent weapon, I'd honestly just say do all base game bosses. Because then you hit plus 15, no problem. And it's like an extra 20 minutes, maybe 25. And it's nothing really difficult. Watch me get hit to Gwendolyn now that I said that. I mean, any percent is a suggestion, not a requirement, so do whatever you want. If you want to stick to any percent first, then by all means. But if you want to go for master run as your first run, then go for it. Like, it does not matter. I wouldn't recommend going for master run as your first run, because you're going to have a huge learning curve. And it's going to take a lot longer than if you just build up your skills over time, but there's nothing stopping you other than yourself. Just not that good. Not very many people are, to be fair. Yeah. I mean, that's what CBD ended up doing with Straight Sword Hilt. It was literally his first run, and it was one of the hardest runs that had been done at that point. This is why it's entertaining. It's fair. I don't like ultras, but it's definitely a switch up, you know? It's also not something that's like unreasonably difficult either. Fair enough. To each their own. I enjoy curved swords because it means they get to stagger lock Ornstein into oblivion. See her lead toward dying death. Okay, I don't know where she is. She's in a weird area. Christ. Thank you. Does that crystal golem have like 680 HP or something? Like, seriously. Tiny bit early. Yeah. It was a bit slow, but it's fine. Thank you. Hey Wolf, how you doing? Thank you for the good luck. A little bit. I haven't finished with Luna City yet, but I have a three hit that are with all very fixable hits. For 100%. Bro, calm the fuck down. Get your ass over here. Thank you, thank you. It's damage. Yeah, Sanctuary Guardian's a bit squishy. I fucking was being an idiot there. Yeah, I kind of threw there on the flip punish. I didn't do what I was supposed to. Yeah, it's a spear, so it's not gonna be bad. Most basic weapons do very well. Yeah, it's in the Firelink graveyard. Oh shit, Tonsu. Hey dude. How you doing? Were you doing Baldur's Gate? Finishing your run? Yeah, thank you for the raid though. I hope if you were didn't finish, it's actually kind of a good thing. Okay, at least you didn't throw it. I was hoping that you at least didn't lose the run. Yeah, but I'll give you a shout out in just a sec once I finish with this segment. But for those of you who don't know me, my name is Caddy Rana. You can call me Caddy. I'm the DS1 guy. I also do Lunacid and Lethal Company recently, so when I'm getting better gear. Silo saving your ass, I guess. Do you really want to risk throwing the run? Yeah, that would be my thought as well. Like, even if it's just 5%, that 5% is gonna feel like hell if it happens, you know? Yeah, but hopefully next time you'll be able to finish it. Let me give you a shout out right now. So yeah, if you enjoy Baldur's Gate 3, go watch Tonsu. They do a fair bit of it. Tonsu is an ex-DS1 player, escaped from the cycle of misery. I'm very jealous. Unfortunately, I'm not able to do that myself. Not really X, fair enough. Fair enough. I know you mostly stopped running because you don't have time. But you get my point. Used to play Dark Souls, now plays Baldur's Gate, and might play Dark Souls at some point again. Power Within and Crystal Magic Weapon. Or, in Tonsu's case, just Crystal Magic Weapon. Because Tonsu's route skips Power Within. Sorry, Matrix. That was only a decent one. Thanks for GG's, though. Yeah, no. Like, in all seriousness, that was a pretty good Manos. I mean, whatever gets you the finish line, right? Fucked up. That one little hill, dude. I hate it so much. It's just so fucking in the way. That was bad. That was really bad. Misplayed on the hill. And greeted on the first tail slam punish, so. So I ran in to Calamite when I knew there was the hill, and so I almost got hit to the next swipe. And then I also greeted on the first tail slam punish, so I was like really far into negative stamina. Which is not what I need to do. Like, it was to the point where I couldn't run through on the second stomp and loop it. Which is a pretty bad mistake. I guess I shouldn't really complain if I get past Calamite. I would like for myself to not be an idiot during the fight like I just was, but as long as I don't die, I guess that's what matters. I just don't like having such bad fights. Damn, that was such a garbage run. Yeah. Kind of, yeah. Okay, winged spear done. Thanks for GG's.